We are witnessing the final stages of a thrilling league season. Ajax and PSV are fighting Club Brugge and Anderlecht for the glory in northwestern Europe. Not only Champions League spots are at stake, but also the domestic pride of the clubs. New heated rivalries are forming within the Netherlands and Belgium. New viewers from across the world all appreciate the competitive title race in the new league as a fresh change to the boring, one-sided established top 5 leagues. And before we even realize it, there is a new, powerful regional league emerging from the shadows in northwestern Europe. It is not only respected and celebrated by fans worldwide, but also seriously challenging the dominance of the top 5 leagues. Now you might be asking yourselves, what the hell are you actually talking about, Thiago, and what are you trying to hype up here? Well, even though my scenario might have been a bit striking, the idea behind it is actually very realistic to happen. What I am talking about here, the new football league that could challenge the top 5, is the concept of the Beneliga. As always, I made a poll on Instagram and 68% of you had never heard of this idea, even though it is one of the most interesting topics for the near future of European football. So in this video, I'm gonna explain to you what exactly the Beneliga is, what severe effect it could have on European football, and also in the end give you my opinion on if it is a good or a bad idea. Let's go! So as you might have been able to tell from the two flags, the simple idea behind the Beneliga is combining the Belgian Pro League with the Dutch Eredivisie. You know, BE for Belgium and NE for the Netherlands. Yep, the idea behind the Beneliga is taking the best teams out of two independent domestic leagues from two neighboring countries, the Netherlands and Belgium, and putting them into one regional, stronger league together. And here is where this idea actually came from. The Beneliga first came up back in 2009 when then UEFA president Michel Platini talked about concepts for several regional leagues across Europe, including one for the Netherlands and Belgium. But 12 years ago, European football was by no means ready for this idea. The whole Dutch football community, from the officials to the fans, heavily protested against those plans. And there is logical reasoning behind that reaction. Back in 2009, the Dutch Eredivisie was far superior to the Belgian Pro League. To give you a clear image, the UEFA ranking of that year had the Dutch League as number 8 of Europe and the Belgian League as number 14. And as per usual, the Eredivisie was producing a lot of new big talents. Apart from creating all the stars from the Dutch national team that was going to finish second in the World Cup just a year later, the league also had emerging players such as Luis Suarez and Moussa Dembélé in their ranks. While the Belgian Pro League 12 years ago had basically no one, it was a bit too early to witness the rise of the Belgian national team. And so, there was no reason why Dutch football would want to unite with Belgian football. But over the course of the next decade, the situation was going to change. The Belgian Pro League has become the origin of the rise of the Belgian national team and so many Belgian stars that are now balling in Europe's top 5 leagues. And even apart from the Belgian national team, the Pro League has produced some serious talent. Milinkovic-Savic, Wilfried Ndidi and Victor Osimhen are just a few examples of quality made in Belgium over the last years. So without any doubt, the Belgian league has grown in recognition over the last decade. And this is also represented in the current UEFA rankings. While the Eredivisie is on the same place as 12 years ago, number 8 in Europe, the Belgian league went from 14 to 9 and they are very, very close together now. This means that by now, for both sides, it could actually be beneficial to unite and build a stronger league together. And the financial challenges that clubs are continuing to face due to the coronavirus pandemic only sped up this process. So who is in favor of the Beneliga and who will probably be trying to prevent it? Here is a quick overview. It has been confirmed that the 11 biggest clubs from Belgium and the Netherlands are openly discussing the creation of the Beneliga. They are definitely in favor of it, they want to make it happen. A problem could just be the smaller clubs in both countries that would probably not be included in this potential league, and they would obviously want to prevent that. And it is also well known that FIFA are very strict when it comes to allowing teams to play in leagues outside of their country. They only approve that in very special cases, so getting them to support a merger of two separate domestic leagues will be very tough. But after all, we also know that FIFA aren't so strict anymore, given the financial side looks good for them. So we will have to see, the decision will lay with FIFA and UEFA after all. And even though nothing is official yet, the talks have given us some good hints on how the Beneliga would look in practice, and here is a very likely scenario. So, due to the fact that the Belgian league's TV contract is still running until 2025, a probable starting date for the Beneliga would be the season 2025-2026. and it will probably be a league made up of 18 teams, with 10 being Dutch and just 8 being Belgian. This is because the number of teams would be based on the population of the two countries, and the Netherlands are slightly bigger than Belgium. And there would probably also be a second division of the Beneliga, including the smaller clubs of the current Eredivisie and the Belgian Pro League. But now, which clubs from the two leagues would actually be included in the top division, the prestigious Beneliga? I made a quick overview for you. So here are the 11 clubs that are already openly discussing the creation of the Beneliga and strongly pushing towards it. From Belgium, that is the 5 biggest clubs, namely Club Brugge, Anderlecht, Genk, Standard Liège and Gent. And in the Netherlands, more or less the biggest clubs, Ajax of course, Feyenoord, PSV, AZ Alkmaar, Utrecht and Vitesse Arnhem. So if or when the Beneliga becomes reality, these 11 clubs will 100% be in it. But 18 minus 11, that is still 7 clubs left for the league. And yeah, these remaining 7 clubs are not 100% sure yet, but here is a very probable scenario with the 7 next biggest clubs after the top 11. So realistically, from Belgium, that could be Charleroi, Antwerp and Zulte Waregem. And from the Netherlands, probably it's going to be Groningen, Twente, Heerenveen and Heracles. So here we go, these 18 clubs could play in the Beneliga starting from 2025, and even though there are still some clubs in it that you might not know extremely well, but the overall quality and the depth in this league is very remarkable and very solid. Now, since the Beneliga is not officially confirmed yet, there are still things that are unclear and still need to be cleared. That is first of all the distribution of European tickets for the Champions League, Europa League and the Conference League. Because naturally, what would you do when combining two European leagues? You would just add up their European spots. And since both leagues, as number 8 and 9 of Europe, currently have 5 spots for Europe, this would mean that the Beneliga would have the most spots of all European leagues, with 10 European spots. So this of course seems weird and unfair compared to the bigger leagues like the Premier League, but I mean, what would you do with the spots if you took them away from the Beneliga? Where would you put them? See, there's still a lot of work to be done, as well as for the relegation and promotion system. I mean, with the usual relegation system of 3 teams relegated each year, you could end up having the wanted order of 10 Dutch teams and 8 Belgium teams massively changed in just a few years. So they definitely need to consider that. And then of course the question, what will happen to the domestic cups of Belgium and the Netherlands? Will they stay separated, or are they going to create a combined Beneliga Cup as well? Or will they just combine the whole footballing system of the two nations from Sunday League up to the Beneliga as a whole? So as you see, there's still some work to be done, still a lot of things to be clarified, just to keep in mind for you. But now, let's get to the most important part. What exactly would be the upsides and the downsides of the Beneliga? What effects would it have precisely? Let's start with the good stuff, with the pros. First of all, of course, the most obvious aspect, the money guys, money talks. And here it has to be said that the Beneliga would bring a massive financial benefit for the teams of both countries. Currently, both the Belgian and the Dutch league generate around 80 million euros each every year from broadcasting rights, from TV rights. That is of course peanuts compared to the top 5 leagues, and it's the main reason why those clubs from Belgium and Holland can't keep up with the top clubs. Now, financial experts have released a report on the effects of the creation of the Beneliga, and they came to the conclusion that this league would generate 400 million in TV revenue every single year. So going from a combined 160 million euros to 400 million euros every year is of course a great development, and it would massively increase the purchasing power of the Belgian and Dutch top clubs. Now, strongly connected to this, the overall quality of the league would obviously be on a different level. If you combine the squad market value of the 18 teams from my scenario right now, you would come to a combined 1.4 billion market value. Now, this would already make the Beneliga the 6th most valuable league in the world right now, even though the gap to the French Ligue 1 is still huge. Now, keep in mind that this 1.4 billion market value come from this low TV revenue of only 80 million euros each per season. Considering the drastic increase in broadcasting revenue if the Beneliga becomes reality, I think it has some serious potential to challenge Ligue 1 and become one of the top 5 leagues in the years following its creation. So these things definitely sound very, very exciting, and it doesn't stop here, because we also have to talk about the competitiveness of this potential new league. First of all, obviously, since we have the biggest teams from Belgium and the Netherlands, there will be more exciting games and more games between the big teams. Because let's be honest, how many international fans are currently thrilled to watch a Belgian Pro League game between Waasland Beveren and St. Truidense? And how many of you can't wait to watch the Eredivisie thriller of PSV Zwolle against Waalwijk? No disrespect to these teams, of course, but internationally, they aren't really a big pull factor. But if you're telling me that Ajax are facing Club Brugge while PSV are battling Anderlecht in a four-way title race, I would definitely pay attention. And considering the fact that, again, these clubs would have access to way more money with the additional TV revenue, these four sides, as an example, could become European powerhouses. If Ajax can reach the UCL semi-final now, what would they be able to do with double the money they have right now? So yeah, that is definitely one point, and another point strongly connected to this is very, very close title races, since obviously right now Ajax would probably be the favorites to win it in the Beneliga, but Club Brugge, for example, aren't much worse, and I could imagine the top six being very, very close together every season, and international fans will surely appreciate a league that is insanely close and exciting while also maintaining a high footballing level. So after all, what it all comes down to is that the international interest for the Beneliga from the global football fanbase will be much higher than it is currently for the Eredivisie and the Belgian Pro League. This of course again would bring additional money, and it would put the Beneliga clubs in a completely different position in the European football hierarchy. The big goal is then of course being able to have the financial muscle to keep the talents that they produce at scale. For example, once Ajax have their next golden generation, the next De Jong, De Ligt, Ziyech and Van de Beek, they would actually be able to keep those talents. Imagine what a team it would be. Not sure about you, but for me, this all sounds extremely exciting. But let's not forget, there's always two sides of the same coin. Now we'll also have to talk about the negative effects that the Beneliga could have. Let's talk about the cons. So first of all, somehow the most common argument that I hear from Dutch and Belgian supporters who don't support the Beneliga is that there will be more traveling and longer distances. While this argument is true, of course, if you combine two countries, of course there will be longer distances, but I still find it very weird because Belgium and the Netherlands are two very small countries compared to other ones in Europe. In this graphic you can see the longest possible distance of two potential Beneliga participants, which is 400 kilometers, 4.5 hours by bus. So I get it, this may sound like a lot for Dutch and Belgian people, but look at the top 5 leagues, especially France or Italy, which are way bigger countries. Some teams are more than 1,000 kilometers apart and yet they don't complain, so I think this is one of the minor problems. And if you want to be a top 5 league, you also have to face the struggles that the top 5 leagues are facing. Let's go to the next argument. It is not unlikely at all that the Beneliga destroys fan culture and fan traditions. Many clubs that would be in the Beneliga have their derbies, their rivalries between the fanbases with clubs that would not be in the Beneliga. And so these derbies would just vanish, they wouldn't be played anymore. And I totally agree with the fans here that this is a very sad development to completely eradicate those regional, traditional, heated rivalries, because those are what defines football, let's be honest. Instead, fans would have to travel to a foreign country week in, week out to stadiums and clubs that they have no connection with, not even a rivalry with, and so the atmosphere in the first years would be very, very empty probably until those new rivalries could start to build up. And strongly connected to this is the next point, because the smaller clubs currently in the Eredivisie and the Belgian Pro League that would not be part of the Beneliga, such as Sparta Rotterdam, Mechelen from Belgium or Venlo from the Netherlands. Those are just three examples of course, but those clubs would just be put in the second division of the Beneliga then, apparently, or if that second division wasn't even created, then they would stay in their respective leagues without the big teams, so those leagues would have no relevance anymore. Either way, they would be massively degraded and disrespected, and imagine right now, in their respective top divisions, let one of them have a great season, a great run, and they could qualify for Europe, whilst in the new system they don't have direct access to European spots because that would be reserved to the Beneliga clubs. So I think the whole concept is of course geared towards benefiting the bigger clubs and leaving the smaller clubs behind completely, and I can understand if they strongly protest against these ideas. And then the last and possibly strongest counter argument is that ultimately the creation of a Beneliga could just be the first step to the creation of whatever you might want to call it, but a sort of European Super League. Because you don't have to be a genius to figure out that in case FIFA and UEFA allow the Belgian and Dutch top clubs to merge into one league, other top clubs from across Europe will want to have the same privilege. Especially those that are already pushing for the creation of a Super League, Juventus, Real Madrid, Barcelona, etc., will see this as their big chance. And obviously, if FIFA and UEFA allow it for some Dutch and Belgian clubs, even though it is on a smaller scale, wouldn't it just be unfair to say no to other clubs? That is the biggest worry that most fans have with this concept, and I can understand that. So now that we've talked about both pro and con arguments for the Beneliga, it is time to give you my personal opinion. To put it simply, I think that the Beneliga brings both Big chances, great opportunities, but also very dangerous risks that we can't ignore. I'm not gonna lie, I would love to see teams like Ajax, PSV, Club Brugge, Anderlecht, whatever, those big Belgian and Dutch teams playing on a higher level than they are now, having bigger opportunities, more power, because they do produce great talents. They've always been producing great talent and great quality, but they never had the financial muscle to be able to keep those talents. And now being able to do that and actually competing with the European elite would be a development that I definitely support, because it brings more equality and more excitement into the world of European football, with teams that are always economizing and working well actually having the same chances as the top teams. But of course, this would only make football more exciting on the top level, because the smaller teams across Europe, and especially in this league then, that don't play in Europe currently, don't play internationally, would only become poorer and have less chances than before. Let's be honest. But after all, I think this is going to happen either way. The gap between big teams and small teams will continue to grow in the world of football, as it is growing in the whole world, not just in football. And there is little we can do about it in the current system. But the Dutch and Belgian top teams can now just decide, do they want to be part of the small teams that are being left behind, or do they want to be part of the big teams? And there I think it is obvious what they are going to choose, and I can absolutely understand this decision. I think for those teams, for example Ajax, PSV, Club Brugge, Genk, Feyenoord, whatever you name it, it is essential to form such a league to break out of the current structures of their domestic leagues if they still want to be able to compete in Europe in the next decades. I think it is just crucial that in case FIFA and UEFA allow this league to happen, if they approve this, they find a way to clearly differentiate it, to clearly separate it from the idea of a European Super League, to clarify that such a league between two smaller leagues, I would say, can be approved in certain special cases, but that doesn't mean that a European Super League can be approved too. I think this is what FIFA and UEFA would have to clarify. And if they do it wisely, I think this can become one hell of a league. It can be extremely exciting, and I have to admit, I would probably become a fan. I would watch the Beneliga. So now that you know what this crazy idea of the first regional league in European football is about, how the Beneliga would look, what upsides and downsides it has, and you also know my opinion, now it is time to ask you guys, what do you think about the idea of the Beneliga? Do you believe it's a great opportunity and a very exciting concept, or do you rather think it just ruins football and it's just crap? Let me know your thoughts down below in the comments. As always, I'm hyped to have a healthy debate with you guys. I'll see you in the next video, and up until then, you know where to find me. Thiago's out. Peace.